Welcome back, everybody, here to our final game of the night for the Gigabyte Challenge Grand Final. I'm Toby One.
And I'm the Capitalist.
And we are here. We are here to watch some serious Dota.
Dota the very serious.
It challenges your mind to understand what is going on. How good these games are. Yeah. If you didn't see game number two and you're watching the VOD right now or over on youtube.com/joindota and you're like, what the hell are these guys on about? Go find game number two of the grand final of the Gigabyte Challenge number six.
It's impressive.
It's worth the watch.
Of throws is impressive.
It's one of those, like, you ever watch like those action movies and you sit there and like you want to watch it all, like, I don't want to watch now. It's like something I might watch while I'm trying to fall asleep or something like that. Uh-huh. But if I stay awake and I watch it, I'm like, I'm still very happy with my movie choice. Uh-huh. That's what that is right there. It's like watching Hot Shots. It's like, eh, I'm okay with that. Sizzling bacon on the stomach, that's completely fine. All right, into the game we go, man, because it's already up and running. So we're going to be seeing our favorite hero coming in, but not with the other favorite hero. So we get Razor as well as the Earthshaker now in here for X Game. And as far as KG go, we have the Doombringer and the Skywrath Mage. So we have the double silencers, the guys who try and battle without talking.
It's almost like they left the Brewmaster in the pool. Like, they banned away Brewmaster and then picked two of the best counters to a Brewmaster. It's like they just hate people talking. That's what it comes down to. They just want to silence everyone. Get a silencer after this, too.
Well, Brewmaster has to be the master of talking, considering he can have a conversation with himself.
Yeah, man.
Split in three different parts, and he's completely drunk the entire time. That's why he's the master of brew. But then again, would the master brew actually drink his own substance? Obviously, you have to have like a taste test kind of thing, but if you're going to be like you do like wine tasting.
You don't brew it
for
other
people, swill it, then you spit it out so you don't get drunk.
No.
Which is a real shame for the wine. And then you try and guess where it comes from.
And then you put all the spit out wine into a
bucket.
And
you're from America, aren't
give
you?
Give it to somebody else.
Like, you always have like those guys walking and around with like the tobacco, like,
kind of like. Yep, every house in America has a spittoon in it.
Hey, I'm just like pushing the generic stereotype of Americans. Radiant team ban. You actually know what it's called?
Yes, I do know what it's called.
Yeah, which obviously just
because I expand my vocabulary from time to time. Toby Wan Kenobi. Dire team ban. Tonight is a very special cast.
Yes.
Special cast.
For those guys that don't know, like when we actually cast tournaments like Gigabyte Challenge, it's meant to
don't
be fun
for
the community.
Don't do drugs, kids. You'll end up like this.
No, I've never done drugs.
Neither have I. Neither have I.
That's very good. That's we're very clean here.
That's because we don't need them.
It's true.
It's got enough personality on the table.
It's actually a guy who was playing with us before, PGG. Like, the entire TI1, because he's got a bit of a problem with drugs. And all of TI1, he was just, like, hunting for drugs.
He was hunting for the green dream?
And he kept thinking...
Shout out to... Nobody.
5 seconds but he kept finding me. He's like, Toby, where's your drugs? I'm like, dude, I don't do drugs. He's like, dude, hearing you up there, you do drugs. I'm like, I don't do drugs. He's like, you do drugs. So every time PGG saw me, it's like winking and nodding at me going, give me your drugs. And I'm like, I don't do drugs. Stop looking at me, PGG. I have nothing. You can search my pockets.
He's
but
like, are you kidding me? I've seen those casts, Toby. You're clearly on something.
I am on the love of the world.
And some of that booger sugar.
What?
I love that.
What kind of phrase that is name. That?
Booger sugar.
I'm really glad I don't know some of that stuff. 10 seconds remaining. Ignorance is bliss.
The white lady.
No, I still find not to know all of this.
It's got to be other names for it.
No, I just stop, Cap. Let's talk about Dota.
Let's talk about. Let's it. Talk oh, about really? Dota. You're gonna keep me on track now, Toby?
I'm taking it away from educating people about drug names. Didn't realize you're such a lord.
I expand my knowledge from time to time. What do you want from me? Batrider and Shadow Shaman going to be banned away by Compass Gaming. We have the Clockwork and the Tidehunter going to be banned out by X Game Kazakhstan.
I love how people think I'm autistic now. It's like, what if I am?
Dire team pick.
If I'm autistic, what would you like to do about it?
Are you flaming Twitch chat right now?
Yeah, yeah. Sorry, it's the same douchebags that are in there every single time going, oh, it's totally autistic. I'm just like, yeah, okay. So, your point. What would you like to do? Let's meet at LAN. I'll have Cathalus beat you up.
Oh, God. Please, no. Please don't force more fights on me than you already do, Toby.
Hey, I've never forced you into a fight.
No, it's just when we're in some sort of, like, crowded scenario and there's angry Germans around, Toby's like, all right.
Yes! Woohoo!
All right, next game, go.
That's what happens when we're in a fight situation and there's angry Germans around. It's the time of my life, baby! It's the time of my life! Just going through the crowd.
No, Toby's actually an adrenaline danger junkie.
Just walking down the streets of Spandau. It's like, you're up for a fight? Bring it on, people! Leave me!
Yeah, Toby would have when the night of Germany versus Ghana, when I was walking home and there was a bunch of drunk Germans around. And they're all pissed because Germany tied with Ghana. They're all so angry. Toby would have been the one running through. Germany sucks. Yeah, go
Ghana. I was like, Barcelona, Barcelona. It was great. It was wonderful. Walking past the Brow House doing that. It's wonderful.
Chad's going to think we're both autistic now.
And what are they going to do about it?
Hey, whoa, we've seen this before. Hold up. Yeah. Hold the goddamn phone.
This is very, very familiar.
We've seen this combination of heroes before. The Alchemist and Skywrath Mage support combination.
Yeah. If I remember correctly,
I'm not saying it's like the worst thing in the world.
We flamed the living crap out of it.
I'm not saying it's the worst thing in the world.
No,
there's
we
just
were
like
saying
this
it
odd
was the worst thing in the world. We sat there 50 minutes into that game trying to understand what the Alchemist was bringing to the game of Dota. And we sat there the entire time going, he brings nothing.
Okay, so the Alchemist is the worst thing in the world. But the Alchemist Skywrath Mage combination isn't the worst thing in the world. It's just there's this odd, unnatural dissynergy. What's the opposite of synergy? Anyway.
Chaos.
Anyway, it doesn't work. It doesn't fit.
It's chaos.
It doesn't fit. It's Skywrath Mage increases magic damage with his Mystic Seal while Alchemist does physical damage with his unstable concoction. It just feels unnatural, you know?
10 seconds remaining.
Toby, don't go anywhere with that one.
I'm not going anywhere.
What is entirely natural is a Visage Drow Ranger combo.
I'm starting to get really tired now.
Because Cloud9.
Don't run around the studio doing that kind of shit.
I was excited.
It's a great combination, man.
It is. Cloud9 is the only team that has really run it, though.
Yeah, because it's like most people get really, really fearful. Speaking as the resident Drow Ranger expert, most people get really fearful about heroes who get really close up against the Drow Ranger. But you notice every single hero of Compass Gaming isn't a jumping hero. They ban the Clockwork, they ban the Prophet, they ban the Tunnel that gets up in your face. Weaver, also being taken out right now, like a very high maneuverable heroes that are real massive problems with the Drow Ranger. But everyone over on Compass Gaming, like, Alchemist tries to get in close. I suppose even the knockback duration time could cause problems for his unstable concoction, depending on when he tries to throw it out there. Invoker, Skywrath, Doom. These are heroes which, like, Doombringer might get a Blink Dagger. And he's, like, at this point, the only person that would jump on top of the Drow Ranger. But he jumps, and if Drow's fast enough with that Gush, he finds himself being staggered back. If he has a Centaur inside of him, it will do absolutely nothing. And what's he going to do? Doom a Drow Ranger? Sorry. That's not going to be what you want. You got a Puck and now a Razor who are also going to be flittering around the fight, causing you a lot of problems, and you've got a large amount of range damage.
Uh-huh.
Spectre is the way they can get in close. This is actually, I'm okay with this Spectre pickup, but it could really kick them in the ass because Drow Ranger hits level 6, you lose a tier 1 tower.
Yeah.
Visage hits level 6, you lose a tier 2 tower. That's just the way she plays.
Yeah, and Compass Gaming have already displayed that Spectre is a really great hero pre-15 minutes. Is able to make a lot of work around the map, get a lot of kills. Toby's too busy studying the Radiant Teen to understand the sarcasm.
Oh, sorry, you would. I mean, look up the top line, would you? Okay. I was just saying.
I was making a joke that Spectre is really good in the early game. Because Compass Gaming won with the Spectre by 15 minutes. But it's
I see what you're doing there.
Please no. Stop. Okay, so the Puck and the Razor are both really good frontline heroes. Puck has a great holding ability in Dream Coil, while the Razor is a good general tank that you kind of need to focus down. Otherwise, he's going to steal one hero's all of his damage and then probably right-click down another hero. So the Drow Ranger is going to work out really well here because they've got four different ranged heroes. They've got the natural Visage Drow Ranger combo. They've got two frontline heroes to be able to make sure that Drow Ranger isn't going to be targeted first necessarily. And well, KPG do the only thing they really can do at this point, which is grab a carry that is also going to be able to get right on top of the Drow Ranger, and the only option you have is Spectre or Faceless Void, and Faceless Void was banned out very, very early on.
Wow, have we really hit this level of Dota again?
Yep.
Top lane.
Yep.
It's just Fissure blocking creep waves now.
Yep.
This is, okay, so...
Well, I mean, when you have an offlane hero like a Razor...
Be careful with the body blocking, though, that Reeves is currently doing. If he blocks this too well, like, if KBG actually didn't even... Like, if this Invoker wasn't body blocking at all, he would actually win on this lane because his creep wave would have reached the tower before. But now it's in, like, the perfect position for Reeves. We've got Smoke Movement coming out, so Skywrath as well as Alchemist. Now, this is when they can work.
Yes.
Early on, we've got Concussive Shot leveled up from PSM, a very unusual kind of thing. Most of the time, you go for the Arcane Bolt. So they're really relying on what? Actually, the Doombringer to get a kill? This dude's got no boots. He can't reach him in time. And Drow Ranger, like, Manus is not obviously not finding some great levels just yet, but...
Uh-oh. That was popped way too early.
Yeah. I'll save a concoction a little bit off target.
It has begun.
Earthshaker's also looking for an opening on top lane. With a Fissure into a Static Link, they can do a hell of a lot of damage. And just, it's
round
not it's good to try and kill them out. Oh, he's going to go for a concoction. And they got Mandus. Concoction, stun,
Sunstrike.
Mandus, he's going to live through this one. He's still going to salve a Babel, and now the Fissure's going to turn in. There goes your salve, slows him down already, and he's locked himself in a tree line. You can't cut through that many trees with only two tankers. He's through one. There's no area around this one. Goddamn's coming back in again with another stun. And it's the Earthshaker who's too far up. Mandus back to full life now. He's trying to focus the Skywrath Mage. Easier kill. Earthshaker still alive. Skywrath, one more attack from Mandus, and there she flies. It's not
enough. No!
28 life points. The Tango regeneration was enough to keep her alive for now. And Doombringer coming back in close again. He's even trying to deny underneath the tier 1 tower here.
How does no one die?
I don't know. This is we're trying to stop thinking about this game in logical terms back in game 2.
This is true. All right. Spectre is, by the way, middle. This is a mid Spectre up against a Puck. This is very
that happens every day.
Yeah. For those of you who haven't tried this matchup at home,
don't.
It doesn't go well for the Spectre.
Don't try it at home. Unless you're the Puck. If you're the Puck, try it at home.
Do it all day, every day.
That is a wonderful scenario. Razor also up on the top lane. This Invoker is 3-for-1 up against a 12-for-2. Obviously, we got to keep our eyes on the bottom lane because we're going round 3 or 4 or 5 or something. Sunstrike, Fissure. Ooh, she pushes him back. Mantis, be careful. It's enough damage for the Soul Assumption. The first blood goes the way of the creep. Oh, Mantis. That's not enough life points. Skywrath Mage, nice return kill. There's that Arcane Bolt, or actually Concussive Shot being thrown out.
And that, I would say, is why you should probably be going Arcane Bolt level 1, Concussive Shot. If you're going with the Doom, right, if there was anybody else but the Doom.
They were looking for the slow. I think the only reason why they tried to do it was because they're looking for the combination with the Sunstrike. That was the primary objective there.
Yeah, the problem is the Doom doesn't contribute anything, right?
No. He doesn't even have a creep inside of him. Like, there's no aura he's even bringing. Puck is dying, by the way, in the middle lane. In fact, until Spectre dives under... Yeah, she could have got the kill then. That would have been still perfectly legitimate for Spectre. I think he might be worried about the phase shift Radiant's and potential to stall him up underneath the tier 1 tower, which is the reason why he's been a little bit more defensive about it. But one more attack is all he needed to kill off that Puck.
Yeah, the last thing in the world I need right now is to have this Spectre somehow get a kill on the Puck after saying what an awful lane it should be for the Spectre. He was really lucky and got a 2-minute regen rune, and he was almost dead at that point.
Look what he also leveled up. He didn't go into the Desolate points. Hey, we're going again. Mantis, where's your Sunstrike? is coming in and predicting where Mantis will run to with the orb attack. It's not enough to get the kill. The Fissure really blocking him out. And maybe with the Gust pushing it back, Soul Assumption, there's not enough mana for it. So he has to man fight it out. But we've already got ourselves a double kill coming
God
the way damn, the Doombringer.
What are you doing?
I don't know. But he is in a really bad position. So he'll TP back to base. We've got a TP coming in as well. And that's going to be from Earthshaker. There's no. He's going to check the trees, but he's out of there. So there's no point even fissuring or throwing anything. He's already out home and host, so 2-3, now on the board.
And I think they're now done with trying to make this aggro tribe work. Once the Visage, yeah, the Visage is now level 4, so the Visage gets a huge power spike at level 3 and 4 because you then have armor for Gravekeeper's Cloak, which makes you a lot tankier as a support. You're no longer that squishy hero that dies to a couple of right clicks. And then you also have that really powerful Soul Assumption nuke. Their time to dominate the lane was level 1 and level 2.
Man, poor Doombringer. He's walked around the entire Radiant jungle, checking almost every single camp, and he can't find a single aura creep. He found like two trolls, some satyrs, as well as like a hill troll priest.
Get the hill troll priest, man. That thing is legit. It gets you the mana regen aura plus a heal. Mm-hmm. It's actually pretty strong.
Raze is coming up for a kill. The Observer Wall was scouting out the movement of PSM. And we've got an Invis Puck as well coming up, so X game. We're looking to be over-aggressive. And I can see why. Jet sitting there with 1 point up in Quas, desperately trying to heal up. Because he put everything else he had into just the 1 point up in the obviously, Invoke. And the 3 points up into Exort. So he's trying to be this sniper. This global sniper. Now we're going to see the Spectre die in middle lane. Or will we?
I don't know. He's pretty tanky.
Orb, Coil, Commit. Coil? No, not going to do it. He's also got Haunt. So without the entire team being ready to kill off a Spectre good reality into you, probably not the greatest idea in the world. And Garsha is trying to look to zone out the Doombringer. But Doom still managed to find level 5. Not too bad for him, apart from having his bottle charge just cancelled then, as he tried to come down for the 6-minute room, which is now taken by the Skywraith.
Yeah, the one plus side of running that sort of... we're seeing this a lot with atypical offlaners. You'll sometimes put two supports with the offlaner just to ensure he gets to level 3 or 4 or something like that, and then you can start moving around the map and leave him solo. Doom is a great example of a hero benefits from that. Scorched Earth, you get early levels of Scorched Earth, you're impossible to kill.
What a fucker. I don't think he realized what he did just then in the middle lane. He's very, very lucky. Are they going to go? Yeah, there's that smoke movement coming towards Mantis. The Gust trying to push him back, but there's just no joy for the Drow Ranger in this one. Yeah, but what a fucker did in middle lane, he left his bottle in this area while he was farming up in this area here. And the Earthshaker saw it, picked it up as he saw two Skywraith Mage Illusions coming towards the bottle. So it's quite possible what a fucker could have lost his bottle at this point of the game. But he carried it himself and took it to the courier. So, smart from
Earthshaker.
Earthshaker
is such a bro.
Yeah. One thing which is just really still massively screwed up is the CS. Like, with 2-4 on the board, okay, Reeves can have himself a great old time here. He actually built into, instead of face boots, Radiant's like, we got the Invoker who built attack. Face boots and the Razor who built treads. The world is upside down right now.
It kind of is, but I think Razor just assumes, Radiant's like, okay, I'm going to be dealing with a lot of burst.
There's
damage.
Your troll trap. Unstable Concoction will fly to Sunstrike in the wrong position. That's not going to hit on Garsha. Now the Fissure hits on three heroes. The Drow Ranger pushing the Skywraith Mage back. Spectre going to haunt himself in. Didn't actually stay on the reality on top of Mantis because it doesn't really matter. He's not level 6 just yet. But now the Dream Coil out from Puck. He's trying to TP out. There's enough damage. Yes, he dies from the Dream Coil. He TPs the mid lane and died from the damage of the TP out of the Dream Coil breaking on him. 3 heroes down for KPG for the price of the Visage. And that's really big for Mantis because that's space for him on the bottom lane to get his level 6. And this is when T1 tower on bottom lane is now forfeit.
Yeah, going for those kind of dives just don't make sense when, again, you have a hero like Doom who doesn't do a whole lot for you. Looks like Doom is going to try and get a kill on the Drow Ranger solo with his ultimate. He's smoked up and everything.
I don't think he can.
I don't think he can either. I mean, he's got the movement speed advantage, so if he actually gets in range of the Doom, he can chase down the Drow.
He still needs help at the end of the day. And what's going to go really badly for him is the fact this Radiant Creep Wave's now coming up.
Get him.
Doom gets spotted. And Mantis tries to gust on the tree line because Doom ran down Sunstrike. It won't connect. Concoction will, however. And now he won't commit the Doom to this. There's no point to it. And maybe, there's no point to it. They do get the kill. And Earthshaker, yeah, she came in then with a Fissure, but didn't throw it straight away. Possibly could have bought a little bit more space there for his draw.
What a fuck, I'm making another good rotation with the Invis rune. He doesn't have Coil yet, though.
Mm-hmm.
Probably going to wait 10 seconds until
he's
has
going to wait for the Blink Dagger to fly in. Because the Blink Dagger is now going to be delivered to Invis.
All right.
So maybe that might flag something for them. Top lane is also being ganked up, and maybe with the Sunstrike Reeves!
Oh,
25 life points, so pops close. The south, and now both Spectre as well as Invoker are low on life up on the top lane. Visage was also trying to be given some space here in the mid lane. He's going to run north right now. Run north right now. Okay, okay, that's not going to work. Drone Ranger killed off Doombringer on the bottom lane in the meantime. But Garsha will die here in the middle lane. Sealed up and killed off by the Alchemist.
Was that one mine?
But Drowell to get a kill on the Doombringer. This is also what happens too when, like, you're able to get just a quick gust off and then just slows a couple of chain stuns. In this case, it's just a Fissure. And you're able to lock him in position. And the tier 1 tower is now going to take a large amount of damage. Man should also be looking to pop off his precision aura too.
Things are getting pretty awkward here for KPG because his top 3 CS on the board still go to X Game. They're dealing with this early aggression very well from the double roaming combo.
And
in general, the Drow Ranger.
They need to get the last hit in this tower. They don't want to let it go. That's a lot of money. They can't just throw it away. And Doombringer is going to come back. Okay, they have to. Doombringer will take the tower. Reeves is on the bottom lane, so they might be actually using the Drow as bait as Alchemist comes down as well. But they're not initiating, and maybe because Skyworth Mage isn't actually in the neighborhood either. And Reeves just shows himself.
It's poor Doom. Doom is a pretty HP high hero.
Middle lane. Oh. What a fuck up. Sunstrike's coming in. The seal's there, and all connect. So the dual combo of Skyworth as well as Invoker. Able to pick up the kill mid.
Doom has no armor, right?
Yeah.
So that's Drow Ranger really beats him up pretty badly.
It's the beauty of Drow, man. Any kind of melee hero which you know you can kite, you're all good to go. And we still have the major problem. The Spectre Haunt is still the only thing that's able to jump in close on top of the Drow Ranger. Now that she has an ultimate, it's actually, like, important that you do get on top of her because the Visage Birds are really going to start to hurt you soon.
Oh yeah, now that we have the, there's another source, a great source of physical damage against the Doom as well, so.
It's the aura combination. Like, the ability just to trigger off the precision aura and then combine up with the familiars, and maybe that was the reason too why she didn't trigger it to bring down that tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. Might be regretting it a little bit because obviously the tower was denied, but saving that for when the familiars need it, that's the important thing.
They're going for a gank on the top lane. The familiars are going to go top with the Dream Coil.
They can't do this, though. Spectre's still got Horn available. Maybe the silence could last long enough, but...
No, I'm pretty sure that they're going to be able to bring Spectre if
he gets jump
close
in.
Enough.
Dream Coil, silence, and the Drow Aura's been buffed up. And now you'll see just how much damage this can dish out. And, well, Sunstrike almost in a good position. Wanna fuck, able to still just TP up safety. And at the same time, Drow Ranger died to the Alchemist. Or at least the Acid Spray. Looks like Skywrath Mage just wanted to get the kill. Mystic Flare
goodness.
And Alchemist combo being used.
This Skywrath Mage is level 8.
How the hell are you at level 8?
They've been roaming around so much, and yet the Skywrath Mage has still been...
He's still 5-0. His net worth is horrendous. Even for all kills you could be looking at for him. Like, he's 4-2-5 right now, but... That's...
Yeah. It's above the other two supports in the enemy team.
Alchemist, it's time to go for the concoction. And he's going to go on Reeves because there's no point going over towards the puck. Then again, Fissure trying to buy some space. Sunstrike connects on Reeves, takes away a lot of his life points, but there's still Eye of the Storm up, and that's only a level 1 ultimate from Alchemist. So there's not a lot of protection for him there.
Did you know that Unstable Concoction Splash AoE hits Visage Familiars?
I did not know that.
He just one-shot the both Familiars as they came in. They're on Reeves, and he threw the Unstable Concoction onto Reeves, and he just blew up both the familiars.
I suppose ever since the change to them, yeah, it should work. Well, now they're going to bring down the mid tower. There's no fortification this time around to try and stall it out. So, that's another tier 1 tower going down. My prediction still stays correct. Drow Ranger, then I'm going to set a tier 2. I should have just set a second tower. Drow Ranger is level 6, first tower goes down. Visage hits level 6, second tower goes down. Mask of Madness gets finished. Third tower goes down. Akin Inceptor on Visage. That's two more towers to take a fall.
It's quite the leap there.
Well, it's
Mask of Madness to Aghanim Scepter for Visage.
That's why I'm like, you had to say Two Towers, because you had to have a bit of a gap. Now Spectre, haunting in, it's on the bottom lane. It's Madness again being zoned out. With Doom and Spectre Ultimate being committed, they can just deny out Madness as well. They're sticking with him, and maybe they get one attack in. Madness, is he going to try and tank this? He's actually tanking up the entire Doom, and then trying to Life Leech out the second he possibly can. So Puck gets the kill. You've committed two ultimates now. Puck, okay, Mystic Flare destroys him. Earthshaker had no Fissure to buy some extra space, but the Drow Ranger stays alive. And they're realizing now how a lot of these gangs can happen. The Observer Ward aggressively planted inside their jungle.
Yeah, KPG have a lineup that they depend so heavily on this. It's all about the Sunstrike, right? It's the only way that they're going to be able to make this double support combo work out successfully. It didn't go so well in the beginning of the game, but it still comes down to the fact they have to make it work. They have to move around with these two supports, set up the Sunstrike kills, because they've invested so much into it.
Doomstead. They might be stunning over on top of Razor right now, but Familiars with the Drow buff up. Actually, where is that Drow buff up? Now she's triggered the aura out. So goddamn, on the run, Soul Assumption damage will bring down the Ark of his Chemical Rage or not. Bottom lane also, Urshaker's in a little bit of trouble. Spectre's coming into the tree line. He's gonna duke him out. There goes the Fissure. TP out of safety, because really, what stuns have they got? They don't have anything. Visage takes out the top tier 1 tower. The bottom lane TP comes in from Waterfucker. No Dream Coil, so there's an easy TP out for Spectre.
Smart though, Waterfucker just successfully defends his tier 1 tower, forces out a teleport from the Spectre. And he already was a part of the kill, so 15 minutes in, he's already got his Blink Dagger. This could be a potential... No. I was going to say, potentially a really early Dagon if he wants to. He's farming that
it's
well.
It's potentially a solo kill right now on PSM. That's what this is. If he can get in range to Blink, Silence, Coil, Orb, and then one more attack and join him way to safety. Very, very smooth. Very, very easy. And meanwhile, up on top lane, they're looking over towards the Spectre again. Static Link will start. Haunt now comes off cooldown, so he's got the option to Haunt out of this one. But not going to want to trigger it off for that. And Madness, okay, there goes your Haunt. He's got to Gust back and get rid of these three heroes. They all get silenced up. The Familiars now come in as well. And Jet with the Fissure. They hold him there for now. Now, Drow did trigger off his aura for this.
Great job kiting around so far.
It's just the basic aura. There's a basic 29 plus damage coming out to these Familiars. I really forget just how much damage that aura can dish out once it's actually activated as well.
Yeah.
Well, okay. Puck is looking at a Doombringer running away. They saw the couriers coming in as well, but the focus is the tier 2 tower. That's what they came here for.
And it's pretty easy to take when you've got these Familiars dishing out so much physical damage, and they can't actually jump onto the Drow Ranger without the Spectre ultimate. It's just unlikely that the Alchemist is ever going to be in a position to lead that stun.
Fish up over on the Skywrath Mage. The Familiars coming in for the Storms. Waterfucker also jumping in very, very deep just then. The Doom's already gone over on Reeve, so there's no Eye of the Storm in this battle, but Madness, okay, he dies very, very quickly. Got isolated and goes down. The Familiars were trying to look for a pick off too, but it's going to go over towards Garsha. Not enough damage. Waterfucker wants to go back in again. He's getting almost a four-man Dream Coil. Yeah, she gets only the Alchemist caught inside that Dream Coil and then just joins himself away. Alchemist about to stun himself. In fact, does do so. The Familiar is watching him from the tree line. But the Four Spirits are causing problems for most of X game. They're losing too much armor when these guys come out. So they have to mop them up. Is he back in again?
He's trying to grab the tower, but now he's going to pay for it as he gets too close to the Skywrath Mage ultimate. Ends up clipping him too much. He tried to go to take that tower, but it still got denied by KPG.
This still works for X game.
Like, it does.
The tower's getting denied is okay for them, because map control is the critical thing. They know the Visage Familiars can basically solo up any hero that just ventures out too far by himself. And they got no easy TP supports in. And
yeah,
Manus, who actually, he went for drums. He didn't actually finish the Mask of Bandits. He went for drums instead. I can understand it considering the amount of fights that keep coming out. So having the aura and the life points, not to mention a little bit more of an intelligence pool, is worth it.
Yeah, the stats versus the nuking power of the Alchemist, Skywrath Mage, plus Sunstrike. He needs just a little bit extra to ensure he survives through the basic amount of bursts. Even if he still dies in the end, it's going to cost extra attention from KPG.
They're forcing a fight in bottom. Four heroes coming down from KPG. Spectre just keeps farming off on the side lane. And it looks like X Game will respond with full force. They're bringing their entire team down here now. This aggressive Observer Ward from the Dire Sight could do a lot of work. In fact, it's already doing so. Manus low on life. There's just Spectre Haunt in right now. And they're trying to isolate it. Manus able to get himself far enough back. Echo Summon and go. And they don't get the kill over on the Dro Ranger. In fact, it's the Skywraith Mage to go down. And Jet's going to follow in. Garsha trying to solo him up. He's going to solo something in 1 second, but it's too long away. What a fucking hour. She's joining himself in. We're so split on this fight. One concoction should be able to kill off Manus, which it does do so as Reeves triggers the Nake, and now he starts a static link over from the Doombringer, who's TPing himself away to safety. Familiar's drop down time won't be there, and they almost had enough damage to kill that Doombringer.
Lived with under 50 health there. Impressive, but Compass Gaming, they're getting a lot of kills. Like, again, I keep going back to these supports and being surprised at how high a level that they are. They're both being level 10. Soon to pick up that level 2 Skywrath Mage ultimate is huge.
They're going,
and goddamn.
Yeah.
He tried to combine it up with Sunstrike plus Forge Spirits coming in. And that's the danger of this. When you max out the Exord build for all that Sunstrike damage, even just a solo support coming in
now
guarantees
you, now you see the combination
damage here
of X game. So Silence to start with, look at the familiar damage output. And they needed to control him just a little bit longer. There's no Dream Call available. He can blink and maybe even body block him out here. But the Chemical Rage, even just that regeneration is enough. Sunstrike's turning around, and so does Goddamn. Familiars will drop down, and PSM's going to be careful about coming in any further out. Even if they do want to farm up these Familiars, they really can't. Yeah, they're going to be careful. They're going to be way too careful.
Mech is going to be up soon for the Doom alongside a Invoker grabbing Necrobook 2. You notice he's holding on to his Necrobook recipe because it makes a little sense for you to get Necrobook 1. It does very little for you. In fact, can be more of a detriment if you actually use the minions. Just because they're so weak and they're free gold. Alchemist is going to pick up his level 2 ultimate for himself as well as the Skywrath Mage because they're farming up the Ancient Stack together. So pretty big upgrades come the way of Compass Gaming, and even bigger if they can manage to secure a Radiance for the Spectre, who is just another 1,800 gold away.
A little bit slower than our last one. Okay, I've seen better tonight.
Yeah. KPG, you disappoint.
Yeah.
Your encore performance of the Spectre.
Obviously, better was seen during TI4 Grand Finals. They're going to come in for Roshan now. Forge Spirits, as well as, well, they got at least a Centaur aura, but they need the Alchemist Acid Spray as well to really make this work. And there it is now. With the Medallion of Courage 2 coming out from him, they can bring down Roshan, but will there be a check for it? Like, the push is coming towards the Tier 2 tower. A couple of pings coming out, and now there definitely will be. Earthshaker was the one close by, and Roshan low on life, but where's your jumping? Garsha's coming in close, but Roshan, now he's dead. Aegis Immortal on the hands of the Doombringer. And you've already got Razor. Okay, turns the ultimate on. Spectre will haunt himself into this battle right now. And there goes your Plasma Field out. Maybe there's enough damage. Doombringer able to get his ultimate off. He's burning down these Familiars. Loses the Aegis Immortal while Manus dies in the back lines. KPG, they've got the upside in this engagement. What a fucking last one left alive for the Centaur Swamp. Coming out from the Doombringer allows X Game to mop up the fifth hero of KPG to mop up the fifth hero of X Game and take a full team wipe. And with Aegis Immortal spent, it's okay. They'll push tier 1, tier 2 mid.
Yep, that means we're going to see a Radiance here for the Spectre as they claim this tier 1 tower in the mid lane. They could also just control the map because they've got the late game Spectre. Spectre, I think, will be able to outcarry the Drow Ranger because the natural advantage of the Spectre is that you get right on top of that Drow Ranger and counter her pretty heavily. The Drow Ranger loses, you know, 60 agility right now when the Spectre jumps onto it. So it's a big detriment in damage as well as the Spectre is just going to be able to threaten the Drow Ranger and force him back.
There's the Gust trying to force him out right now, and well, concoction over to Manus, also keeping him out of this fight, but the tier 2 tower's already gone down. This is something X-Aim weren't really expecting to have to fight up against just yet. When you're fighting up,
Sunstrike!
Reeves moves up, but the Necro units right behind him, saying, Reeves, just attack me once! And the attack will actually be taken by Garsha. So he'll take the damage out from that one, making sure there's no risk whatsoever to his core. But that was like a level 3 Necrobook was purchased an instant on the 21-minute mark. Or 22-minute mark.
It's amazingly good timing from KPG. And they're doing a good job. Like, the one thing I kind of respect is that they're utilizing this Alchemist better than last time we saw support Alchemist, which is they're continually stacking up this Ancient stack. This is twice now that they've gone back to farming up Ancients as both of these supports. And it's one of the few advantages that an Alchemist gives you that no other melee initiator can.
Yeah.
Well, Tidehunter, if you want to run him as support, but his time as a support, I think, is long past.
Yeah, and it's really paying off. You can see this graph here, like that drop down, like that's the start. That's also the team fight, but this is like kind of like the point before it where they found out the first set of stack.
Yeah.
So the advantage is through the roof. They're sitting at 8,500 to 9,000 gold advantage. Their experience is 15,000, and it just continues to increase. There's a hyperstone over on that courier as well for goddamn. Like the support is almost with a full assault cuirass. You give him one small camp, and he's actually got it. So you add in that much armor buff up, combining with the power of a mech, and then Spectre with the Radiance Burn, they're getting survivability, as well as the ability to kill.
Yeah, it means Drow Ranger isn't going to be able to do anything in these fights, because even if she is able to get a BKB, you've delayed your damage significantly by going that BKB. You add in the fact that the enemy team is going to have this armor aura. It just means that Drow Ranger is not going to cut it in a lot of these first couple of team fights.
It's almost like Drow Ranger is just there for Visage right now. Like that's the Drow Ranger's primary objective is to find level 16 somewhere across the map, keep the BKB up, and just keep as much range back as possible. Stay alive. And let the familiars do a lot of the work with Puck and Racer also on the front lines. Let them soak it up. And once the BKB is there for Reeves, the potential for that to happen is a lot higher. Then Drow Ranger can get some space to move and work. Even with Spectre ulting in, if you're far enough back, you should be okay. You should be okay for the initial portion of damage that comes from it.
Another tier 1 gonna fall. KPG already having such a huge net worth lead. Have just evened out the tower. In fact, they haven't even evened it out.
There's a blink to Echo Slam right now. They're gonna be careful when they make this many minions. They could lose a lot of heroes if they group up too close, too tight. But that's, I think, that's the reason why the acid sprays out so far. Man, it's, whoa, yo. I mean, so we're talking about sitting at the back end there. He's so far up, and now Invoker, Tornado, Meteorite, Deafening Blast. Man's in half life. He tries to throw at least one gust, but it's too late. And the familiars aren't finding the opening. At least Goddamn's going to sun himself up and waste his chemical rage.
And they don't go soon.
Down.
If they don't go soon, they're going to lose out. Not only is their tier 2 going to fall eventually.
Let's jump Doom right on top of the Puck. So no Dream Call, no Silence. And now you've also got that Haunt coming in. And where is this Drow Ranger? She's all the way back at base, not even involved. And she's lost her entire team. The Bind Base come out from the Puck so we can be involved in this one. Man's back towards the front lines, and they're gonna try and bring down the Spectre. Nice four-star away, maybe almost enough. It's too much damage coming out. The Drow Rangers come online, just brought back so we could fight. They turned Mystic Flare, helping out. He turned up the Cold Arrow, so there's a little bit more lifesteal coming in as well for Mantis. And well, where's your Sunstrike? It's looking for the kill over on Reeves and won't be able to land. But Mantis gets the double kill. And that kind of almost feels like, well, I'm not going to say it was a bait to die, but he accepts the fact if he died, he could just buy back. Courier actually gets sniped as well by Waterfucker. He chased that thing across the map.
Yeah, even the best professional teams get caught in this trap where they feel like they're winning and they go and they start pushing out aggressively, but they don't take into consideration that early buybacks can really screw them. And that's what happened. KPG were actually in a great position there. Yep. Earthshaker jumped in, tried to go on the Invoker, popped his full Echo Slam, and then immediately died afterwards. He just couldn't finish off the Invoker. So that was a great start for them. Doom jumped in aggressively, taking another hero out. So it was essentially 3 versus 5 from the get-go. It's just KPG ended up overextending themselves, where they really should just focus on taking the tower. Mm-hmm. They had the Spectre. Like, there was no real reason. I was going to say before that team fight occurred, there's no reason KPG need to try and force anything because they have the Spectre farming the opposite side of the map. So not only are they going to get the tier 2 eventually with some of their siege push, but they're also freeing up a ton of time for the Spectre to farm, where X Game are actually 5-man grouped up at that top lane. So they were getting the better trade off of stalling, and yet they still tried to force the fight.
Yeah. That's just when patience becomes your virtue you're acquiring. And now smoke, phase shift out just so we can blink. And there it goes, into the tree line, orbing as well to jump in deeper. And a way to safety. So it didn't just go straight for a TP because he didn't actually own one. And gets a way to safety. I also want to flag the fact that Mantis now level 16. So Drow now has the bonus 80 agility coming out from the ultimate. As long as she can keep the distance. Are they looking really? Whoa! Okay, it's slowing down the push. That's all that really is. Even Yule's opening the Doombringer up and towards the air. Again, the Alchemist, however, is just farming up Ancient Area. But besides keeping the push going too, how far away is he from Aghanim's? Okay, maybe he's died a little bit too many times. We should watch the bottom lane instead. Now, Silence goes straight on Doombringer, and then it goes. He got the Doom off at least, but he's dead straight away. And where is your push coming? Throw Ranger, Manus triggers the BKB. Beautiful. He's focusing on the Spectre, and this is really problematic. Reeves, however, is still having a large amount of problems. And Spectre, he actually TPs away inside the trees. Nice Yule Scepter up. The Concoction goes on Manus. That'll stop his TP out. And KPG are turning this really, really nicely. What a fucker. He even can't get himself out to safety. The Invoker takes a triple kill here. The Urshik is able to get himself out. It really looked like X Game had the start of the fight completely under their control.
Yeah, one of those scenarios where you kind of needed the Visage Familiars with you rather than split pushing. It was pushing down the mid lane. They got a decent amount of damage on that mid tower, but KPG, when it comes to straight up team fights, X Game need every advantage they can. They can't afford to have the Familiars not being there, even the Visage himself. So this is something they're going to have to consider, is they shouldn't really be trying to fight, I don't think, KPG anymore. I know they're going up against a Spectre, and I don't really like their chances going into late game, but you just have a BKB on the Drow Ranger. I think you need much, much more. You need to be able to have Aghanim's on the Razor. He also needs a level 3 ultimate that's going to be up pretty soon. The Visage also has halfway to his Aghanim, so there are some items coming up that will change the team fights pretty dramatically for X Game. They just have to have the patience and the strategy to be able to dodge these team fights from KPG and continue to farm up rather than trying to brawl out for every tower.
Well, for now, man, they do at least have some kind of space. The Razor spawning his farm on that bottom lane. Drow Ranger has respawned, so she's trying to find it here in the middle lane with the Urshaker babysitting. But it looks like Roshan's also become that key point of KPG. So just over a minute before the big man's going to respawn back up again. Still seeing that Invoker like breaking so much of his net worth. He's about to pick up a full Scythe of Ice. In fact, there it is with 90 gold to spare. Garsha up on this top lane. There's an Invis Rune Doombringer trying to have a bit of a search for him. Now, Garsha's not in that crevice, so Doombringer will be able to find him here, which means... Oh, wait, yeah. Turn around. Let's the Doom off. Spectre doesn't actually have to reality into this one to get the kill. In fact, probably still shouldn't if he can actually reality again. But I suppose he's facing down Manus at the moment, so probably wouldn't be the greatest idea to come into the middle of the rest of X Game.
Yeah, he just makes the judgment call that with the Visage.
Waterfuck is in trouble. Waterfuck is in a lot of trouble. He's actually going up towards the high ground. Gonna phase shift and jump himself away to safety. And Forestuff is already used by Jet. Goddamn will send himself up. That tornado is actually decent in length, not massive. It's only 3 points up in Wex. Deafening Blast, though, slowing him down. The Gust over on the Skywrath Mage. There's no follow-up damage. Hides in the corner. Out of Dream Call, and then orbs himself away. Menace fighting from the low ground, however, triggers the BKBs. Will evade the Stumble. The Fissure going out from the Urshaker, combining up with the Eye of the Storm of Reeves. He's actually able to lock in the energy, kill off the Invoker. The Unstoppable Streak is now being ended. It's a huge amount of money coming in for the Razor. Goddamn will go down as well to the Drow Ranger. Razor, actually, he's finished up his Aghanim from those two kills. That was worth so much money for X Game.
It's unbelievable. I can't believe X Game are actually turning this game around quite heavily. I really thought that with the Radiance, KPG had everything they needed, but they're doing a good job. One thing KPG are not doing is focusing on the Drow Ranger in these team fights. Every single time, they're actually letting Drow Ranger get away with just kiting one or two heroes, and they're not five-man focusing her down. But
there's
man.
Two buybacks. They're coming in to try and fight this one, man.
They better hope they can
Alchemist,
defend this.
Already a good initiation. Silence over on Goddamn. Now he can throw it out, but he's going to send himself the Familiars. They could also drop down, keep that stun going.
Okay, Spectre!
He snatches the Aegis to the Immortal. The Skywrath Mage dropping the Mystic Flare. It's not enough damage, and now, well, the Aegis Immortal will be triggered. Reeves locked in a corner here. And, well, Visage wants to help him out, but he's sealed up. There's your orb jump away. The Drow Ranger actually fighting here as well. This is not going to be great. He's being isolated out and then burnt up. While the Familiars, they don't have a drop down again. They can't keep this push going. Garsha TP's himself away to safety in time. That Deso effect was not enough.
Man, that was such a beautiful play there from Artis. Jumping in, grabbing the Radiance, grabbing the Aegis. They're really lucky. XGM are super lucky they did not lose more heroes. The Razor as well as the Visage easily could have gone down. That could have been a whole entire Puck as well, was in a huge amount of danger, almost got hit by that unstable concoction. That was almost a disaster game-ending fight for X Game. But KPG, hey, props to them. I thought they were going to buy back for nothing there.
Yeah.
I thought they were actually going to lose Roshan and buy back for nothing gained whatsoever.
Still at the end of the fight, man. X game, they keep it level as far as trade goes, because they did take Roshan, they took the experience and the gold from that one, and you see it in the graphs. Like, the gold is sitting in a flat 10,000 right now. And as far as experience goes, they were 15,000 behind X game, and now they managed to drag it back to be about 7K. Mm-hmm. And really, at that end of the at that Roshan fight, it was only a small amount they lost.
You know, I really thought that the Compass Gaming were just going to start like steamrolling. They had the Necrobook 3. They had Radiance plus a Vitality Booster at one point in time. They had everything they needed. But X Game are about to get some big upgrades. Remember the Aghanim Scepters that I was talking about earlier? Those are beginning to come online. So the Aghanim's is already up for the Razor. He can just go for like some straight-up tank into a Refresher, like a Vitality Booster into a Refresher next. The Visage one, which is normally one of the most important Aghanim Scepter upgrades in the game, is doubly important when you have a Drow Ranger on the field where you've got a third unit to be able to get that precision aura to.
He really needs that too. But it's only 600 gold or so, or 500 gold away.
Yeah, he's close.
So with the top lane already being pushed out here by Jett, this giving him the space to do so. This tier 2 tower is somehow still alive on the top lane too. Can't be denied because it's 10 points of life away from denial. Yeah, Bagasha's now going to, well, okay, he's not going to grab all of it, but majority of his final 1k item he'll get here. What a fucker. Nice little orb. Scouts out the Doombringer hiding in the tree lines. That's Doombringer. Is he actually building into a Scythe of Ice as well? Or is this meant to be, it should be a Shiva's Guard. But normally you'd think plate mail before.
I would
not
say,
Mystic Star.
Yeah, he's definitely going Shiva's here. As he probably just got a whole bunch of gold off of a team fight. Happen to have, you know, 2,700 or even more, and went, I'm going to go for the more expensive item first. Even though normally you would say, yes, it's better to have the plate mail because really Doom isn't lacking in mana. He doesn't really have mana issues, so having that amount of intelligence is
necessary. Concoction movement. Blink, blink!
Nice.
Skywrath Mage gets the perfect follow-up.
Good pickoff.
And now Spectre, well, they find the puck inside the tree line. The dagger's going to be coming out, but they don't have any stuns, and they don't have enough damage to kill him off in time, even though that orb damage from Skywrath is quite high.
Scythe of Ice soon for the puck, but I don't think it's going to be up in time.
You're still getting split pushed out right now. Like, the Familiars are keeping the top lane pressured in, Man's keeping the middle lane pressured in, and then he just goes back to farming up his own jungle. He's almost finished his mana style on top of the Helm of the Dominator, which he also has with the BKB. And the second he finds an Alpha Wolf and puts that Alpha Wolf straight behind him, the damage output of X game is then increased again. This is where Drow Ranger actually gets really scary with, not even with the Satanic, with just a Helm of the Dominator into the mid game, where you can grab what, well, KPG are walking around with. You have the Pack Leader's Aura. Obviously you don't get the same crit, because it's not being made part of you, but still a lot to play around with. They found Mantis.
Doom.
Spectre doesn't have Haunt, but he has Dagger, and now there goes your Doom. And then, well, Reeves turns on his own abilities, and Mantis, he's low on life, coming back in range of his own teammates. They get the Fissure off, they do. Now Mantis, A3 life point, Sunstrike, Denial just comes out from the Passage. They just want him off the field, and they can turn themselves, their attention over towards Jett. Meanwhile, over in the middle lane, we've got the Doombringer killing off the Earthshaker, while Jett gets isolated over on the side tree lines. There goes your Razor. So it's a 2-for-2 trade. Drow Ranger actually bought back, so it's actually a 3-for-2 trade. But the Familiar Birds, they're getting the buff up, and that's the main reason why he's buying back. PSM, he's actually surviving through all of this, while goddamn, he's in the middle of the engagement, looking for a concoction, and he's not gonna get it. Jett with a double kill, however. And then, while they keep going again, Mantis throwing out a couple of the Frost Arrows. The Spectral Dagger will survive long enough, but the Familiars, they've still got stuns available. He's going through two different tree lines, and now Familiar, they got to chain their stuns correctly here. Oh. But they got it down too late, but the damage has already been done. And that's going to be from Mantis coming in behind. They got the silence off from the puck, and then the follow-up Frost Arrows.
Well, looks like we're going to have a pause. So, Compass Gaming. I'm watching these team fights, and I'm going, what's really going wrong for them? And for me, I think it just comes down to lack of team coordination between the five of them. They're not focusing their targets very well, and when they do, they're oftentimes focusing the wrong one. So I think that's been a pretty big issue. Even though they've been controlling this game for 90% of it, they have some overextensions where they don't need to. They're just not playing a very clean game, and that's giving X Game plenty of opportunities to make the comeback. And that's not to take away from X Game. Their play has actually been pretty superb with the Drow Ranger, especially picking his opportunities in team fights pretty wisely. Coming in at the right times when the focus, the lockdown, the focus on Compass Gaming, they tunnel vision onto one hero, and then the Drow Ranger comes in from the side, and next thing you know, I mean, you're getting to a point where the Drow Ranger is going to be able to eliminate probably two heroes within a BKB time if he actually gets onto some of the squishier heroes like the Skywrath Mage. So I honestly see there shouldn't be any issues for Compass Gaming in these team fights yet. They just keep on making the wrong decisions, and X Game are soon going to be able to punish them. If they can get that Scythe of Ice, it's going to make a big difference going up against certain of the like tankier heroes that have a lot of extra armor, or even the Spectre, and just holding him in for a little while. It's going to give Drow Ranger more space to work around, and same goes with the Razor as well. You know, Razor is a hero who gets stronger over time in team fights due to his damage steal, but also the Eye of the Storm. So the longer they can draw these team fights out, the more room they can work around for their two cores. Razor and Drow Ranger, I believe, can actually outcarry the Spectre. I still give the advantage to the Spectre up against the Drow straight up, because you can just instantly jump on the Drow Ranger in melee range, and that's a huge advantage for you. But the Razor is getting bigger than I ever expected him to, and they still have the late game potential from their Puck as well with that Scythe of Ice. So this essentially a three position Puck now. He like the Razor and the Drow Ranger are taking over the carry roles. The Puck is still going to be able to contribute a lot because of that Scythe of Ice pickup. Yeah. Earthshaker and Visage too. Two of the highest damage dealing supports, I would say, going into the late game. They're not heroes that transition to semi carry by any means, but
they're able to do something. We're good to go again, as the people with extremely weak bladders have managed to get themselves back over towards their computers.
Is that what it was?
Well, yeah, it was two water closet breaks.
WC, I see it.
Yeah.
Is that a water closet?
Water closet. I don't know why people say water closet. They say here in Europe, we always just call it like the toilet. Yeah. That's wrong. But for some reason, yeah, they just call it WC, and I'm like, oh, okay, so you're all architects. Because toilets are always classed as WC. Mm-hmm. Just a singular toilet as well. Not a bathroom, just a WC. It's literally
what I
a
love,
closet with a toilet.
What I love about a Drow Ranger, especially with Puck. Puck is a hero that really benefits from it. Look at the Puck right now. He's hitting for 200 damage a hit.
Yeah. The hilarious thing is, too, I still have flashbacks to the days like when Puck was... When Drow Rangers first got buffed up with a different aura, and it was 2.5 years ago. Back when Warcraft 3 Dota was actually still played. And it was the guys down in the Philippines that were actually doing this. They ran offlane Puck, and they ran a safe lane Drow Ranger.
Yep.
And the Puck won the lane based on physical DPS. It was a phase boot first, Dagon second Puck. And he just killed everybody. Because it's just, you won on range damage.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. I remember there was some same laning situation. Back in the day, used to be that the Puck would actually get a Ring of Bacillus. And the reason the Ring of Bacillus was because it's such a strong laning item. It gives you armor, so you're taking less damage from their right clicks. It also gives you damage, so you're doing more. It gives you more mana to be able to spam out. With a Drow Ranger on top of that, your damage on the Puck was pretty insane early on. So it's a combination that has been run back, going all the way back to Dota 1, and you can see how successful it is.
This is going to be KPG. Okay. She's nighttime. They don't see each other. Well, Razor sees them, and in they come. And Razor instantly hexed up. There's your Echo Slam from Earthshaker. They sealed him up. PSM got possibly the best deal of his life right then. There was no follow-up fissure, which means they can bow this one out. Reeves tanked up the Doom. Jed's hiding inside the tree line for now, and Garsha is getting sliced up. He's able to get one last familiar. Reeves summoned back up again. That orb damage is almost enough to kill off Reeves, but he got out of the Doom and Meg charge off. So he's fine, and what a fuckers thing considering jumping over. Doom level death's available, and he actually stops Reeves from TPing out this one. What a fuckers trying to come back over to help him out, but there's also support coming in from the Spectre, so he's got to leave Reeves to die. Drow Ranger has gone completely AWOL, going north up the river, while Waterfucker will be able to TP successfully away to safety.
Every single time I look at a team fight,
And I make this calculation. I go, okay, this team's going to come out on top. And every single time, it's the exact opposite. I don't understand. Like, X game, somehow the Razer goes in. They knew they were initiating on Compass Gaming. They saw them going to the creep wave. They knew they were going to get the surprise factor. And yet still, somehow, the Razer didn't get off his Eye of the Storm and BKB in the beginning. Which meant he also didn't get off his mech at all.
That's four-man silence jumping into the middle of KPG, who are going high ground right now. Troll Ranger is back at base healing. New ultimate orb as well being picked up, so there's still a large amount of damage. Remember, these three familiars are also in the field of play. Sunstrike, what do we got? Yeah, Sunstrike was looking for a bit of a pickup, not going to find anything. But they lost one of the familiars. This is really not a great thing for the Visage. Still another 82 seconds to have these guys come up, but you're just thinking about how much damage you lose by losing just one familiar. It's too much, but looks like KPG going to back themselves up. The courier scanning for Roshan. It's almost max spawn time on this Roshan. But they've got a full Shiva's Guard as well coming in for the Doombringer. So new items are starting to arrive, and there it is. 1 minute and 10 seconds left for Roshan to spawn up. This will be our next big contest spot, because there's no way X Game can allow KPG to have an Aegis the Immortal and push high ground.
Yeah, unless it's a fairly even fight, this should be what determines who takes the win here, because the Aegis on either one of these carries is just going to overwhelm.
Look at the move. They're trying to check early. EMP Tornado is going to go right on top of Mana, so he's already down to 2/3 of his mana. And wait.
Yeah, what if I could just jump directly into the pit? Because they had no idea whether or not it was up.
Oh, now the movement. Dust. Oh, he's actually jumped able to get himself away. The Fisher holding out the Doombringer. And maybe with the Dream Call, Visage again going to go down. These familiars, they've got to drop. And there it goes. Holding the Doombringer in position. Yule Scepter keeping that puck alive for now. While Manus is still trying to battle up against this damn Spectre. But with Reeds moving over, Manus can get some extra space on him. And also not get desolated up the entire time. But Reeves now on the sidelines, and they're losing everybody. Puck will die on the sides as well. And now KPG, Roshan or not, they need to push middle lane and take that Rax.
Yeah, they can. They're just gonna five man down mid. If there aren't mass buybacks, they'll take the Rax and then back up and do Roshan. If there are mass buybacks, they just back up and do Rosh. So it's a win-win scenario for them.
Well, as far as buybacks go, man, Visage is the only one with buyback. Everyone else doesn't have buyback available. They're short money, so they're going for double raxing here. We've got bottom lane being taken out by Goddamn. We've got middle lane being taken out by the rest of the team. And already actually just sniping out familiars up on the top. They can't drop down, so they've actually lost all their familiars as well. This is mega creeps.
Yep,
I don't think they're up in time. This is actually full mega creeps. Next game, maybe when they respawn, they can try and fight, but the amount of damage that can be dealt in 58 seconds is too much, I think, for them to actually like contest this game again.
Yep, Alchemist by himself is taken down. There it is.
The winner will belong to KPG. My lovely Dro Ranger will not be able to take a victory in this game. But I think both teams had opportunities to win this grand final. So many opportunities to win this grand final.
Yeah, there was the problem with the last team fight was that the Drow Ranger was completely stalled out by the Spectre, which is what we talked about time and time again. It just we weren't seeing it in any team fight. The Drow Ranger was caught in a really bad position with the Spectre on top of him, and he couldn't get to the team fight. And Spectre just right-clicked him down, and there was nothing Drow Ranger could do at that point in time. Mm-hmm. So that's the advantage. Like Spectre was a great pickup there from Compass Gaming. It made a ton of sense. Didn't really support it in game two this time around, though. Game three, way better. And was an excellent way to go up against the Drow Ranger. Really, X Game just could not take enough early control because their whole entire lineup was actually going to come down to more mid-game and pushes, and this game stalled out too long for them. They didn't take enough control early on. Compass Gaming were actually winning a lot of these early team fights with the Skywrath Mage and Alchemist bouncing around, and then they just transitioned that into good mid-game control. They made a lot of mistakes going into the late game, but in the end, they still had the power to be able to win it.
And that they do. So they take out the grand final of the sixth installment of the Gigabyte Challenge, taking home €1,500. €500 get to go over to the boys from X Game as well, find their way as well through open qualifiers. But KPG, the dream is alive. They came all the way through the open qualifiers. They win the grand final. You could do the same thing as well next month. The Gigabyte Challenge will return. I say next month, which is literally tomorrow. So keep your eyes peeled over at joinoda.com for the next edition of the Gigabyte Challenge and when you can sign up for it all. We advertise it all over there. And of course, you can follow us on our Twitter and Facebooks, and we'll also let you know over on those networks. For now, though, if you want to watch the VODs, they'll be uploaded within the next few hours over to youtube.com/joindota, where you can check out the previous games as well. And you can also stay tuned for the most exciting rebroadcast since TI4. It's literally the first one we're doing, actually. Yep. So, yeah, stay tuned if you want to watch everything which we had today. There were definitely some entertaining games. So that'll all be starting up in just a couple moments' time. So thanks for watching. Myself and Cap wishing you a very good night. And we'll see you live tomorrow at 15 CEST when Arrow will be going up against Scythe in the Joint Little League Asia, which you can also buy tickets for. They're also in the store. They got added in today. So enjoy. We'll see you next time in the live stream.